something like this, you moron!
Why would the spirit world be run by a toddler?
Don't point your finger at him!
And to think I was scared of the mighty King Yama!
Well, to be more exact, I am the mighty Kawinima, and I am the son of King Yama. Even though I appear to be a child, I've been around over 50 times longer than you have, so watch your mouth when you speak to me.
So it takes hundreds of years to move past a diaper.
Can't you show an ounce of decency?
Actually, I'm proud to say that in addition to knowing the greatest secrets of the universe, I'm also quite potty trained. Now let's skip to the business, shall we? Yusuke Urameshi, I present you your ordeal.
My ordeal is a golden chicken egg?
Your ordeal will be what is inside of it, and I assure you it won't be a chicken. Hatch this egg and face what comes out.
So what's the trick? Do I do something to hatch it?
No, not at all. You only have to keep it with you. This is a spirit beast, and it feeds off the energy emitted from your soul. This will be a true and constant test of your character. The things you do and feel will change the monster inside, for better or for worse. If, as would be expected from your files, your spirit is wicked and cruel, then the beast that hatches will be the same way. It will devour you, and you'll be lost forever. This, as you might imagine, is a very painful experience. However, if the energy you emit is good and true, then so will be the spirit beast. It'll take care of you and guide you back into your living body. Of course, if it sounds too risky, you can opt out and remain as a ghost. The choice, Yusuke Urameshi, is yours.
I can't believe I did that.
Yusuke, I'm afraid you don't have time for reflection. Kawinma said that until the ordeal's finished, he'd keep a pulse in your body, but that won't help if it's cremated at the funeral.
I forgot!
Can't very well be alive if you don't have a body to live in, now can you?
Oh, give me a break. Then what are we waiting for?
Thought we weren't stopping.
Well, how do we tell him to keep my body 20 feet from the nearest oven? Is there any way for ghosts to communicate with living people?
Yes.
So are you gonna tell me?
You can just stand at their bedside.
What do you mean?
Human beings are more attuned to the supernatural when they're asleep, and so ghosts can talk to people in their dreams.
Well, I'll be darned.
You fool!
Why? What were you thinking, Yusuke?
No one gave you permission to die! You got hit by a car! Strong people live through that!
That's what I'm saying.
She's got one more excuse to act that way. She won't listen. Let's move on. I think I know someone who will. Look at that. Her room's become a lot more girly since we were kids. Hey, what's up, Keiko? She's crying. What's wrong?
Yusuke! Yusuke, wait. Yusuke, wait.
Listen to me, Keiko. I need you to pull yourself together. I'm coming back. It's hard to explain, but I'm a ghost right now, and I have to take care of this egg, and then I...
Yusuke?
Hey, are you hearing me? This is important!
You're heavy.
I need you to take care of my body until I come back. You've got to tell them not to cremate me, and tell my mom not to waste her life away because we're gonna be fine. Mm-hmm. Well, I guess that's it, Keiko. I'm coming back. I don't want to see you cry anymore.
Oh, Yusuke! But he was, I thought, was all that really just a dream? No, I'm sure I felt him.
Hmm.
had the strangest aunt? Story about Yusuke. Yusuke was living in some other world full of ogres, and he kept knocking them down until he became their leader. Sounds like him, doesn't it?
I dreamed too.
Oh? Was it like mine? Then maybe it was true.
Yes, maybe.
This dream your mother had seems to give her comfort, and Keiko doesn't want to take that from her.
Well, while she's being comforted, I'm gonna be a barbecue. Botan, is there any other way to communicate with living people? This dream business isn't gonna cut it.
Do 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 do. Boing.
Oh. Jeez, you're killing me. I mean, call me crazy, but I think as the messenger of death, you'd know how to do this.
Well, if the dream communication isn't working, there's always the final method.
You always this vague?
Under the final method, you talk to Keiko by taking control of someone else's body.
Oh, right. I've seen that in movies and stuff. You mean like a possession?
Yeah, sort of.
Can I do it with anybody?
Well, no. There are some rules. First you have to know them, and second, they have to be unusually aware of the supernatural.
In that case, I'm screwed. There's no one like that. Is something the matter, Kuwabara? Do you think we're being followed?
I'm feeling a chill.
Gee, maybe it's the flu.
I doubt it.
It's just the tickle feeling kicking in.
The tickle?
That's what we call it when Kuwabara starts detecting the presence of ghosts around us.
Yeah, it's true. I've had the tickle ever since kindergarten. Voices chase me home at night. Scary old women whisper things to me in my dreams. Well, sometimes they're nice. Usually they're not. I think it's because they know I'm kind of a natural leader.
What a surprise. That goof actually has a purpose.
The ghost monster's behind me, man. It made a noise.
Are you sure?
Is it the scary old lady with the axe again?
No, it sounds more like a puny low-level ghost, like a haunted raccoon or something.
I'll show you, puny you. You can forget it, Botan. There is no way I'm taking control of that lame brain.
Here's my impression of Yusuke. Look at me, I'm burning. Good.
What's wrong, man? You look a little pale.
Earth to Kuwabara.
All right, he's ready for the taking.
Okay.
But I've only given you 1 hour before the effect wears off and you're thrown to the outside. A human body like Kuwabara's couldn't stand any longer than that. If you miss this chance, there probably won't be another one, so do the best that you can.
I will.
Hey, Jamie, out! I'm inside Kuwabara! Feeling smooth!
Looks like he's back to normal.
Out of my way, punks! Now!
So much for normal.
Daughter! I need to speak to your daughter, Keiko!
Who do you think you are, cowboy?
I don't have time to explain! Where's Keiko?
Why should we tell you?
Because
it's me, you guys! I'm Yusuke!
Yusuke was never ugly like you. And for your information, he was killed in an accident this week.
How can you be so cruel?
We were close family friends with that boy, and your joke's not appreciated.
Coming here to harass our daughter on the day of her best friend's funeral.
I tolerate a lot of crud in my life, but bad manners is not on the list. Allow me to show you the door.
I might look different on the outside, but on the inside, I'm really...
Have some respect.
That could have been better. We should have special passwords for times like this. Man, only 45 minutes. Damn it, where could she be?
Well, if it isn't Kuwabara from Sariaski Junior High.
Get off me! I know what it looks like, but I'm telling you, I'm not Kuwabara.
sunset. You can hit me all you like.
Sorry, but I don't take requests.
Oh, then take this.
Punches that hardcore besides Yusuke Urameshi.
Darn, I'm giving Kuwabara a good name.
Kuwabara, it's time for me to even the score.
And me!
Unbelievable. Does Kuwabara pick a fight with everyone he meets?
Attack!
Fun, but probably not so good on the time situation. Keiko, I think those are Keiko's friends. What a save.
I hope Keiko will be okay soon.
For our sake as well as hers, people are starting to say things.
Hey, girls! Weird.
Only 10 minutes till I'm booted out. I'm never gonna find Keiko now.
Sorry about that.
Huh? Keiko?
Where'd they go?
Pull it together, Yusuke. You found her, but now you've gotta convince her quick that you're not just some ugly weird guy with bruises on his face. No time, no time. Okay, I've known her all my life. There's got to be something between us that only I would do.
Yeah. Keiko, nice uniform.
That's so squishy!
I'm exactly who you thought I was, Keiko. I'm Yusuke.
Huh?
I don't care what any tough guy says. Your punches hurt the most.
Don't tease me, Yusuke. Is it really you? It's too strange. Why do you look like that?
I borrowed somebody's body, but only for an hour. I know this is weird, but you have to believe.
Whether or not I believe isn't the question. I knew it was you from the first time you spoke. I know. And it's not just your stupid gags or how you laugh. There's ways you move and speak that in 100 years I wouldn't forget.
Whoa, now.
Don't cry. We'll save the mushy stuff for another day.
Then tell me what's going on. What's next?
Next, I'm gonna give you my message before this dummy gets his body back. Which, by the way, happens in about a minute. Now, I guess you could think of this as sort of a rental car, and I'm about to lose my license. I'll say this as straight as I can.
I'm taking this test to get back, and I'm trying hard not to fail. So just trust me and take care of my body until...